All right. Well, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I want to thank George Wood for the Where's It Wednesday theme. This isn't necessarily Where's It Wednesday. It's actually, I admit, Excel 2007 does this one better. This is a question that Chris asked at the Springfield, Missouri conference. She said, VLOOKUP, there's a way to make sure that VLOOKUP never gives us an NA. And if you're in Excel 2003, this is relatively a painful process. You have your VLOOKUP, and what we have to do is insert a new bit of formula equal if open parenthesis is NA, another parenthesis, and we want to check and see if that VLOOKUP is equal to NA. So here I'm going to hold down the Shift key, hold down the N key, and select all of that formula right here while editing the formula and do Ctrl+C. Now I press End and put a closing parenthesis to finish the is NA. Now I'm working in the if statement. If it's NA, then we want to put something else, maybe a zero or a quote quote. I'll put a quote quote here, and then another comma. If it's not an NA, well, then we want Excel to do the VLOOKUP. So I do Ctrl+V, and basically what's going to happen is it's going to do the VLOOKUP twice. It's going to do the VLOOKUP first, and if it's an NA, it puts nothing like we have right here. If it's not an NA, then it goes ahead and does the VLOOKUP. Well, they improved this dramatically in Excel 2007. Here's what we can do. We have the same formula in Excel 2007. We don't have to have Excel do the VLOOKUP twice. We use a brand new function that they added to Excel 2007 called IFERROR. Okay, now I know we've had IsError for a long time, but this is brand new, called IFERROR. Basically, we have our VLOOKUP as the first argument, and then a comma, and here, what to do if we get any kind of an error from that first formula. So, quote, quote, and what we'll see is this NA down here in row 19, when I copy this formula down, will change to a blank. If error, much faster and much easier way to get rid of those NAs in Excel 2007. Now, of course, the obvious problem is, if you use this function, you can only send this workbook to other people that have Excel 2007. Otherwise, the old Excel will return a name error. It doesn't know anything about if error. So, great question from Chris. A couple of ways to solve it, whether you're in Excel 2003 or Excel 2007. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.